Okay, this one, in this you write down like this question, no? In this you write down the dehydration of primary alcohol. Dehydration for this question I'm talking about. Dehydration of primary alcohol follows E2 elimination reaction. E2 elimination. So the most important thing here it is what? We have E2 elimination, so there is no carbocation formation. So here rearrangement won't be there. Okay? Since it is primary alcohol, so it follows E2 elimination. E2 elimination, it's a one-step process, no carbocation forms, hence no rearrangement here. So how do we write down the product? First of all, protonation of this hydroxy group. CH3. And then CH2 positive charge. Okay, now in the next step we have base, conjugate base B minus. It takes H plus from this, the alpha carbon. It takes H plus from this. This comes, this bond pair comes over here and this goes out as a leaving group. Okay, so the product of this reaction is, without any rearrangement, is CHCH3 double bond CH2. No, I am writing this here to make you understand. But all these things happen in one step. Oh, one thing is I made one mistake here. This hydrogen is here. This hydrogen is here. From the beta. Take this
beta.
Carbon is 5.1. Okay, so here you must remember, if it is primary alcohol, then E2 elimination, no formation of carbocation and hence no rearrangement.
So here there won't be any product where the double bond is attached to the ring coming outside.
Here it is not possible. Since it is primary alcohol, so it's one step process, no carbocation comes.
Can the plus charge transfer the CH?
No, it is not forming actually. Carbocation is not forming. This goes out. This base takes this H plus, this comes over here. All these things happen in one step. One degree alcohol follows E2 elimination. Let's write down. Done. See, we can also use POCl3 for this purpose. Phosphorus oxychloride we can use for this purpose. Okay. The reagent is POCl3 with pyridine. What is the formula of pyridine? Around 0 degrees Celsius, the reaction time. Okay. So if the product is, reaction is this, CH3OH, and when this reaction takes place with POCl3, with pyridine, around 0 degrees Celsius, the product of the reaction is CH3CH, double bond CH.
Thank you.
So that becomes an H.
Which?
No, so like
this bonds have pyridine with nitrogen. This is the purpose of this pyridine. It extracts H plus from this.
So,
does that mean that
the
acid?
So, like the
conjugate acid? No, this is different reaction. It's not like it's different reactions. We're using POCl3 in pyridine solution. See this PO, this one is a good leaving group. It's a good leaving group. That's why it goes out easily from this.
So is it better than chlorine or bromine?
Yeah, you can say that. It's a better living. That's why we convert this. The purpose of this pyridine to convert this into this POOCl2 so that it can go out when H plus comes out from this. It's a good living. So basically,
so how do we determine if the leaving group is like better than something?
For leaving group is nothing but the negative charge, whether it is stable on the atom or not. Okay, so if it just goes out, you see O minus is there. So negative charge on oxygen is more stable than Cl minus or Br minus like that. That's how we get it.
So this only O matters, not
these groups actually matter, because this entire group is going out like this. So this is a living group, this entire group is a living group.
What is the cost of the do after that? They can't remain that
long. That will be in the solution. H plus will be in the solution. The purpose of pyridine, it is behaving as a base. This step is an acid-base reaction. It donates lone pair, takes H plus from this. Okay, so apart from concentrated H2SO4, we can also use this reagent at 0 degree Celsius for this reaction. Okay, next write down.
So why do you have to cool it? Is it an exothermic reaction?
What?
Is the reaction exothermic? So like why do you have to do it at 0 degrees?
It is exothermic reaction. Because a strong bond is, sigma bond is getting break and weak bond, pi bond is forming. So overall energy releases in this process.
Is
this
simple for cooling
an upside down? No, that is heating. No, it's not like this. Yeah. No. Cooling me likha rakha the reaction. On cooling. Write on the next reaction. By dehalogenation of vicinyl dihalide. Write on. The reagent used for this purpose are, the first one we can use NAI in acetone, NAI in acetone, and the second one zinc with an acid, CH3COOH. Ethanol also we can use.
So ethanol with zinc or just?
No, like we can use, the first one is NAI with acetone, CH3COCH3. Or we can also use zinc with CH3COOH or C2H5OH. Okay, write down this reaction follows E2 mechanism Okay, so this reaction, vicinal dihalide, is this. We have halogen present at the adjacent carbon atom. This is vicinal dihalide. Okay, and when you heat this with NaI acetone, C double bond C, it forms IBr, NaBr, and this is a double bond forms. Or if you use this with Zn, with an acid CH3COOH, it forms again the same product with ZnBr2 boson.
So what's the mechanism?
Mechanism is not triggered. I'll tell you how to, you know, memorize this reaction.
So why won't it work with dihalide or something?
Seminal dihalides, there are two halogen atoms present in the same carbon atom. Okay, so this is not helpful because that carbon halogen bond becomes highly, you know, weak in presence of free electron. Again, metal gives electron, right? That becomes weak, and hence the two carbon halogen bond gets breaking. Here, what happens? It goes out. This bond pair leaves over here, and this goes out. So it is going out from two different carbon atoms. When it is on the same carbon atom, for that also we can use, but the method is different. For the preparation of alkene method, we'll see that method also.
So, over here, can the two halogens be different?
Yes, possible.
So
then the product will be.
So then will it require two modes of reaction?
No. One will go with iodine, other one will go with this thing, Na. Enzyme will get ZnCl, then we have two modes. For this purpose, we generally take same halogen atom. If different, then we take two modes. Okay, write down next plan to this. Right now, we can also use the other metals, like other electropositive metals. We can also use the other electropositive metals like Na, calcium or magnesium for this purpose. Na, calcium or magnesium.
So we use these in acid.
What?
So we use these metals in acid. Like
these metals, instead of zinc, we can use these metals. Okay, write down the product in this reaction. The first one is reaction. First one, product.
So will we just get a double bond between OH and NEET? Like OH will go and then over there we get a double bond.
Yeah.
Double
bond. Okay, what is the carbocation we get?
Yeah.
And then?
Methyl
shift or hydride shift. It's 1-2 methyl shift.
So
right?
Why do you need to do methyl shift?
You can hydride shift to the other side. Right?
What do you want to shift?
No, you have more. It is over here.
It
has 0 alpha.
Tell me,
it's 2. So why can't you hydride shift to the bottom position?
Your positive charge?
Yes, sir.
And this?
Yes, sir.
How many alpha hydrogen here?
Four.
Yeah.
Over here it's
two. One, two, and two. Three.
No, sir.
No,
it's two.
Just two.
How many we have here?
One.
Three, four, plus two. More stable. And you can see this is turning 3 degrees.
Okay, so for methyl shift, the 3 minus B shifted doesn't have to be ethyl because they're exchanging like one H with one methyl.
Anything can shift. If it is ethyl, so that also is
big. It doesn't have to be ethyl.
No, if you have ethyl suppose here,
yes, sir.
Then we'll shift ethyl group here. Sorry, methyl group here. Because this ethyl stabilizes this because of I effect.
So what if I had like a dodecyl? Could I have two dodecyls? If I have one, sir.
No, in that case, there will be some ring formation. Large compound, no? So it forms something. So that, like in general way, we cannot say that.
Like no matter how big it is, we can always shift it.
Purpose is to get more stable carbon atom, right? How do we check this? We'll check alpha helix, that is. So whatever you are feeling, just shift and then you count.
So why would it form a ring?
Large ring, no? Large compound. So it's a tendency to form a ring because any large compound, polymers if you have, quite has some helical structure. You must have seen the structures of proteins. Very complex structure goes like this. It was very large, the size is big, right? And there are some positive negative charge present into this. Here it is not the case, but there we have oxynitrogen present.
Yeah.
That develops some charge onto this. Because of that, some attraction is there, weak Van der Waals attraction, and it forms an helical ring. So when you have a large compound, it has tendency to form a ring. Because in the ring form, it's more stable.
So when there's methyl, ethyl, and you shifted methyl, then ethyl, if we had, it had less alpha hydrogen, one less, compared to if we had shifted the ethyl itself. So because it would have CH2 in between.
No, then we'll shift ethyl only. The purpose is to get more stable. We'll shift ethyl. Okay, so this is the more stable carbocation. And then finally what happens, when H plus goes out, so the number of product that we get here is, one possible product is this. The another product is, any other product possible? These are the three products possible. The most stable one is the first one. Major product is this, then this and this. Okay? We'll take hydrogen from this carbon. You have hydrogen. We can take hydrogen from this carbon also, or we can remove hydrogen from this carbon also. These three products. Next step, may the base will take H plus from the adjacent carbon atom. This H plus goes out, double bond here. This H plus goes out, double bond here. This H plus goes out, three products. Okay, now in this one, we'll have a carbocation here. Right, and then H plus goes out from this. And we get a ring. This is stable. This is stable through dancing resonance. One more product possible.
So because dancing positive makes it so stable, wouldn't it want to keep the positive charge?
Doesn't make that stable. This carbocation is stable. Right, but
it's not
so
more
this
stable,
won't convert into another form of.
But it won't be more stable than these two guys.
No, but this two we cannot compare. This two we can compare. You know, charge is species. This is different one. This is different. SN person. Right, you cannot compare horse and bird. This is a good
compare. Horse to horse. The first one is stable.
In this two, this one is more stable. Right, we can compare this one. Okay, now tell me one thing. If suppose we'll expand the ring here, then what is the product we get? Ring expansion effect. What is the product? Ring expansion, what is the product we get?
We're not supposed to shift.
No, I'm just asking you. Question is, suppose I'll give you this question.
So square with those two things.
Tell me the product of this, if ring expansion makes
sense. So square with those two things and one problem.
Wrong, that one. Okay. See, how do we do ring expansion? We'll number the carbon atom first. Starting from this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 carbon, so we'll draw 4 member like this. Properly. Okay. Now here, 1 and any one of this bond we can break. Either this one or this one. Suppose I am making this one. This comes over here and this 4 attach onto the first carbon. So 1 attached with 4, 2 and 3. Which one has the positive charge?
2.
2, second carbon. So here we have the positive charge. Right? And first carbon has 2 methyl groups, right? 1 and 2. Okay? And then what we can do? 1, 2, methyl shift, not hydride shift. 1, 2, methyl shift. So one of this methyl group shift over here, so get this one and the positive charge. Okay? And finally H plus comes out. So the possible product here is this one or this one or this won't happen, but if ring expansion will be. Sometimes they may ask you, write down the steps involved in the conversion of this and this. Suppose they'll give the product like this. Write down the step involved into this. No, if the question is write down the product in this, then we'll write this one. Okay, not this one. In this one, which one is the most stable? First one. Okay, let's write down. One more note you write down into this.
This has nothing to do with this.
Nothing, I just give you one more. I forgot to give you this. One more thing I forgot. Suppose we have a reaction, say CH3, CH2, OH. Okay, and this reaction is taking place in presence of a compound, say CH3, OH. CH3O- and CH3OH. What is the product we get into this one? We have done this. What is the product we get? CH2 double bond CH2, right? This, when the temperature is less than 140 around, 140 or 150 degrees Celsius, 145. Right. Then what happens? The product of this reaction is CH3, CH2, OCH2, OCH3. We get ether apart from alkene.
So that will also form. Alkene will also.
At this temperature. Here the temperature is more than 170 degrees Celsius. So you have to memorize the temperature also.
So what happens between 140?
Between one and two forms. Both products.
So below 140 only forms.
Below 140 you have ether. In this case actually, this is behaving as a nucleophile, not base. So this attacks onto this carbon atom.
So but isn't the definition of a Lewis base a nucleophile?
Lewis base, maybe you have.
So, what's the difference then?
No, Lewis base is tendency to lose electron, except electron.
No, sir.
Lose electron. Tendency to lose electron is base.
Yes.
Nucleophile is where the negative charge is more stable, except to be a better nucleophile.
Oh.
Right. So, it is other way.
Isn't it when it's less stable, it's where nucleophile?
See, if you have this CH3O-, okay, if it is a better nucleophile, this will attack easily, so it should be
less stable.
So depends upon the stability of charge, you can say whether it is a better nucleophile or a weak nucleophile, okay?
So, but I mean, my question is, isn't a base and a nucleophile?
No, it's not.
But the definitions are...
Base is tendency to lose electron.
Yeah.
And when this negative charge is less stable, right? So this will attack onto any electron deficient site. So tendency for this to attack is nucleophilicity. Base may behave as a nucleophile.
Yeah.
But whether the better base or good base is a good nucleophile, we cannot say.
So how do you define a good base?
Good base is what? Tendency to lose lone pair of electron.
Yeah.
And good nucleophile is what? When the electron density is more, and it attacks onto the electron. Tendency to lose lone pair is base. Tendency for this molecule or ion to attack on it, onto any electron deficient site is the nucleophilicity of that particular.
So, sir, a base is good whether or not it attacks on an electron deficient site. Like it can lose electrons anywhere and it's a good.
No, it depends. Acetone loses electrons. It depends on the condition, right?
Ionizer.
Huh?
It would just be those who just split up into ions.
There are many definitions. Constant acid, hydroxide base, Lewis acid, Lewis base. We are talking about Lewis base, like lone pair carbonation, etc. So, tendency to lose OH minus is again a base, basic nature. We are talking about in terms of Lewis definition.
So can a base be a good base by some definition and a bad base by another?
No. See, Bronsted base, we cannot say it is a Bronsted base and Lewis base. Because definition is different. Bronsted base is tendency to lose OH minus. Lewis base is, talks about what? Lone pair. It's completely different. OH minus. So here you see, when you have temperature less than 140 degrees Celsius, you'll get ether as the major product. So this reaction is very important. Temperature dependent reaction, less than 140, you'll get ether, not alkene. Okay? In between these two, you'll get mixture of both, alkene plus ether. Okay? Next write down.
So what's the mechanism of the ether thing?
Ether goes to CH3, CH2. OH. Right. So from this H plus, this goes out as H2. Right. Yahan pe aa jayega H plus, positive charge, then this goes out as H2. This will have the positive charge on it. Then this CH3O minus attacks on
the H. So where is the H plus stuff?
From this solvent, H plus. Okay. This goes out and this OCH3 attacks on here.